I'm Joe Lawler for the Washington Examiner. I'm here today with the Chamber of Commerce's Tom Donohue, and we're going to talk about the elections, policy, politics, and everything that comes under that umbrella. So thank you very much for being with us.
Well, we're glad you're here. Let's do it.
All right. Well, let's start off with talking about 2016. You are laying the groundwork now for this cycle and getting prepared. Can you talk about what's in store and how it's going to compare to the past few cycles?
Well, first of all, let's start with the fact that when we're looking at 2016, while as citizens and people responsible for leading the business community, we're very concerned about the presidency. But this institution does not do presidential politics. We do presidential policy, which means if people come out with some very extraordinary or outlandish comments, we're liable to have something to say about that. Now, where we do work in a political sense is in the House, in the Senate, in the state Supreme Court, with the state attorneys general, governor's races, and odds and ends that are important to our agenda. With that as a background, this is going to be a very, very significant set of elections. People believe that the House is safe for Republicans, mostly because we're in a situation where there are maybe 40 or 45 contested seats in, 10% of the seats. But that's not the whole question. Do we have the right Republicans and do we have the right Democrats in those seats? We went out in the last election and we looked for candidates that wanted to lead, that wanted to govern, that wanted to make the economy work, that wanted to make the country stronger. And in the instances where we thought that was important, we challenged other candidates in primaries and in open elections with the people that we were able to recruit, much to the chagrin of a lot of people. But we did it, and we're going to do it again. We're really, really good at doing a lot of things around here. I mean, we're really good at analyzing issues and explaining them and writing about them and holding meetings and conferences about them and lobbying on them and going to the press on them. We want to get better on closing the deal. I mean, I suppose everybody that works in a legislative and political sense, whether it's in a state or whether it's in the United States or Canada or Mexico or Germany, where they all look for ways to be more successful. I think we're doing all the right things. I just want to press harder with our own team and with our own members and with our state and local chambers around the country that we're doing so much better with over the last years. On politics, on legislation, on trade, but we want to get very, very focused on a small handful of issues that we need done now, and we're pushing very hard. And by the way, in those issues, we're telling people up on the Hill, this is a really important issue. And by the way, we're just writing down how you're voting.
We've now had several months of GOP control of the House and Senate. I knew coming in it was a question, can they govern with majorities in both chambers? How do you think that John Boehner and Mitch McConnell have done demonstrating that they can govern?
The best way to figure that out is go up and ask your Democratic friends, and they'll tell you, thank God, the Senate has gone back to regular order. For 5 years, we didn't have a budget. We didn't have hearings. We didn't have the process where we could offer our own amendments, where we could debate our own issues. And look what happened. It cost us the Senate, and we're in a position now, at least, that we are going to have an opportunity to be seen by our constituents, to advance opinions that may be different than the Republicans. But the normal order has given us the right to legislate again and to do what we were elected to do. And if you look at the first 15 or 115 or 120 days, I don't know how many we're up to, But, you know, we're back to normal order. We've Democrats and Republicans are working together on budgets. They're working together on the doc fix. They're working together on Medicare and Medicaid, which we couldn't get anybody to work on for a long time. They're working together on trade. And the bottom line is we're a hell of a lot better off today than we were at the day of the election.
Of course, the real test is coming later this year, keeping the government open, raising the debt limit, funding the Highway Trust Fund, a number of other, renewing the Export-Import Bank, which I know is a priority for your organization.
So who is it a test for?
Who, do you think that the center will hold? Do you think that the Republicans, how do you think Republicans will come through?
How do you think Democrats would come through?
Well, they're not in the majority right now.
No, but they want to be. And that's the real issue, because in the next election, there are more Republicans, by a factor of two probably, when you really get down to it, at risk than there are Democrats. And the issue is, who is going to be able to go to the people and say, this is what we did, this is what we supported, and this is what we believe? Because a bad choice in that regard will probably have a lot to do with the elections. And that's when I asked, that's why I asked you, you know, who's at risk here? Who's being observed? And it's not just Republicans. Democrats now have, they like having normal order because they can do and articulate and express their views. But they now have to be careful of the views they express, because the American people, they may be, American people are working very, very hard, you know, long, bigger families, meaning generational families and all that. American people aren't stupid. They may be uninformed, but when they get uninformed, they make sound and thoughtful choices. And I think Democrats and Republicans alike have to be very careful about what type of stuff they're trying to sell the Republic, trying to sell to the public.
It's not manufactured controversy, though, to say that John Boehner does have a big caucus. He's got a lot of members with different viewpoints, and there's increasingly very conservative populist element, he's going to have trouble working with them, not just to fund the government, but also on some business priorities, as you well know, Export-Import Bank, it's a big fight. Immigration is another issue. How do you view that faction of the party? How do you work productively with them, exerting a lot of influence within the Republican conference?
We need to get down and get leadership in this country that is capable of leading, that is ready to lead, and that wants to put us in a position to prosper. I think Boehner has demonstrated that when it comes, the chips come down, he passes what he has to pass. We will do something on infrastructure that's better than what we're doing this week. Mm-hmm. We will do things to deal with the whole question of immigration. And in fact, if we don't do something to deal with immigration, it's going to make it a lot harder in 2016. Look, it's better to have the type of problems than John Boehner has than what they had under Harry Reid in the Senate, where the way they dealt with it is to do nothing. Boehner will make the Senate do what it has to do. You know why? He's a guy of great courage, and he doesn't need the job.